Hi, this is Leif of Macworld, and today we're going to look at the best note-taking apps for the iPad and the Apple Pencil. Now, I've actually been using my iPad this way for a long time. I like to use it kind of like a legal pad as opposed to something that you type on and everything, and the Apple Pencil makes that really convenient. The really good news is that there's a lot of apps already on the App Store that allow you to do this, even though the Apple Pencil just now came to the smaller iPad. So today, let's try some of those out. So the first app we're going to look at is Apple's own Notes app. It's Apple's own stock app, so you shouldn't expect any big features in it. So down here, basically, you have a pen, you have a highlighter, you have a pencil, you have an eraser and a selection tool, and assortment of colors. You can also choose if you wanted to have lines or you want it to be unlined, but that's about the extent of the customization you're going to get with this tool. One thing I really like about it is that the pencil actually looks like you're writing with a pencil. Believe it or not, that is really hard to get in a lot of note-taking apps. But another really amazing thing about this is that the selection tool is extremely accurate. It'll pick up the line if you want to move a section of the text. And because this is Apple's own app, it works directly with the iPad interface itself. So very nice. If you have an Apple Pencil, you can just tap on it and boom, you don't even have to unlock your iPad. You can scribble a note. But again, it's very bare bones. So the next app we're going to look at is Notability. And if I were to tell you to spend 10 bucks on any of these apps, this would be the one I would tell you to spend 10 bucks on. I'll tell you why, because it's the one that I have actually bought, and it's the one that I use frequently. I use this app almost every day. So you have a lot of the same features as Apple's does. You know, you have the pen, but the difference is you can actually adjust the stroke width here, which you could not do with Apple's one. You have a lot more colors here. You have the highlighter, you have the eraser, a cutting tool, and just something there that allows you to, you know, move around the text. You also have you can actually just write by regular text using a keyboard if you want to. But the most amazing thing about Notability, and which makes it more notable than any of those other apps, is that it feels exactly like writing with a pen. So many apps don't get that. They feel, you feel like you're still using a stylus. But this one, it actually feels fluid, and I think that's really important. Nobody else nails that quite like Notability. The other thing that's really nice about this is, other apps do this better, I should say, is that you can take the selection tool and you can click on it right there and convert to text, and it'll actually, see, it actually misread it there, but I was trying to say dog, and this is what I mean by some apps do this better, but it's not the best one, and so converting your handwriting into text is still very much a work in progress, but it is possible if you write super neat. The thing you have to remember with a lot of these apps is that often you're not really writing neat, so don't expect perfection with that. One final feature that I really love about this is that you can start recording up here, and it will take, so if I'm writing this, later on, I can go back to these notes and I can press on this, and you'll hear the actual audio that was being saying while I was writing dog is black. This is really helpful if you're in a lecture hall taking notes and you're writing by hand and you want to see what your professor said. Alternatively, you can also import PDFs, mark them up with this app, and you can also change what the paper looks like. There are many different varieties of colors here. You can, make the paper gridded just like you could in notes, but there's a lot more options here. But basically, anything you want a handwriting-based app to do with your Apple Pencil, with taking notes, not necessarily making art with it, you can do it with Notability. So the next app we're going to look at is GoodNotes 4. GoodNotes 4 is still a really great app. I wouldn't call it as great as Notability, but one of the really cool things that it does is it allows you to categorize your subjects by notebook. So say, you can change the art here, you can change the paper. And so you can create that book and gives you a really good idea of having like different subjects. So we would, just like a regular, notebook that you buy at Walgreens or something like that, you got a subject heading for that. And then you can start writing it here. So let's do something right here. Now, the problem with this, as I see it, is this is an app that basically mimics the feel of using real paper. I actually consider that a weakness, because one of the amazing things about digital ink is that, technically, you should be able to just keep scrolling and writing as you want. With this, you're basically limited into how the page looks, which is the way paper used to be, which makes it convenient for printing out, obviously, if you want to, and you can do that with this app. But the problem is, it really limits you in what you do. But this one still has a lot of good options. You know, you have the highlighter, you know, you can erase, you have the selection tool, and you also have a really cool feature in that which you can basically use the shape tool to make perfect shapes, more along the lines of what you want. So let's make a circle. Let's make a triangle. And see, it'll basically make them on your page the way you meant to make them. So much like Notability and a couple of the other apps we're going to be looking at, it does recognize your text, but unlike a lot of these other apps, it doesn't try to give you text that you can paste into an email or something. However, it does allow you to search through your notes, which is kind of cool because it'll actually recognize what you wrote. And sometimes like video or this will show up. I doubt it could read Macworld here. But one feature I really like about GoodNotes 4 is that you can use this little zoom in tool, you know, so if you're typing, if you're writing along, as I should say, and you remember something, so I want to put a big note up here. So boom, as you can see, that shows up in the actual text here on the page, but it's a lot smaller. And especially when you have a lot of text going here, it's a lot simpler to get that in. So the next app we're going to look at is MyScripts Nevo. And Nevo is really cool because handwriting recognition is its thing. It's a fairly simple app otherwise, but you know, you can't really adjust these lines. You can't put the grids on there and everything, but it is absolutely fantastic at handwriting recognition. This is what it is meant to do. So let's write a line out here. So I wrote the sentence, "This is a video about apps." And I don't know if you can see it, but it came out perfectly in text as I was writing it. And so there's none of this circling it and everything else. It does it immediately and it does it very well. The problem is, again, you're really stuck in this one structure, but if you're just interested in getting your, you know, translating your thoughts from handwriting into actual text without doing a lot of, you know, retyping or something like that, this is a good app for doing it. Now, the problem is, as a person who writes a lot by hand, I can tell you that if you're taking notes and you're in a classroom or something and your professor is going, so let's see, I want to say the nearest star to us is the sun, and he's saying that. That's me being, I can actually read that, but it came out, "The nearest star to co-ed he AMA." So that gives you an idea. If you're really rushing to write something down, maybe you have better handwriting than I do, it's gonna, you know, you're not gonna have an easy as a time. And I should say, you know, this works best with a print-based handwriting system as opposed to cursive or something. So let's write my name. Yeah, see, I was looking all pretty there and it's put leg. So if you're writing, you know, the way it wants you to, writing along the lines, writing in basically, you know, a manuscript, non-cursive script, it will do really well. Other than that, I don't know. But if handwriting recognition is what you want, Nevo is a really good app for it. So Apple fans, get this. The next app we're going to be looking at is actually a Microsoft app. This is Microsoft's OneNote. Now, there's a good chance that you've actually used OneNote before. It's a very robust app, especially if you're taking text and everything like that. You can insert photos, you can insert tables, files. But since we're working with the Apple Pencil, this is what we're going to be focusing on, the drawing section. Now, in a lot of ways, it's very similar to Apple's own app in that it's got very simple tools. You know, you have the pen, you have a blue pen, a green pen, a highlighter, and some other stuff. And the nice thing is that unlike Apple's Notes app, you can actually adjust the stroke width and stuff. So let's take a look at it. So far, so similar to anything else that we've written. And let's add another one. Now, one of the reasons why I really love OneNote is a lot of these, you can't really, you know, let's say I want to scribble in something in between here. As you saw, sometimes I had to use like a magnifying tool or something. But watch this. I can actually insert more text in between here. For me, that's very amazing, especially when I'm writing like handwritten drafts and I want to insert another paragraph or something. Boom, I don't have to rearrange the whole thing. And another really amazing thing, especially if you're using this for like a corporate group or something, is that you can actually add people to, you know, you can invite people to collaborate on this notebook with you. And if you think this is a small space, so let's add a little blue here. Check this out. It gives you a massive range. This is a massive board to work with. So this little bit that we were working out of here, the opening page, that's right here. This is the whole screen that you have to work with. So if you're trying to use mind mapping with your colleagues or something like that, this is a good way to map it all out. Unfortunately, this means that you can't easily export it to PDF like you can with some of these other apps. But, you know, for the chance to collaborate, having a nice, easy place where your notes are stored in the cloud, available anywhere you want them to be, it's an excellent app. So the next app we're looking at is Notes Plus. This actually used to be my favorite handwriting app, but later on I found that Notability had the really fluid writing, and so I went over to that. But other than that, it's something that really gets what it's like to write with a pen on digital paper. You're not really necessarily limited to the actual page that you're working with. You can keep writing, you know. So, you know, if I have this here, you know, I can just keep moving it and just go on forever. And that's a really amazing thing to do here. Now, another thing, as you saw, you know, with some of the other ones, you know, I can use this to zoom in to say something else. So it's, so if I need to really, you know, zoom in to write something, I can do that. Now, the really cool thing about this one, in my opinion, is that I can't believe other apps don't do this, but if I make a mistake and I want to scratch it out, look at that. I can just scratch it out. That's such a simple thing. You think that would be very intuitive with the rest of apps with the Apple Pencil, but this is the only one that I know of that really does it. And I think more of them should do that. As with other apps, you have, handwriting recognition. That one actually did recognize me saying dog. So, hey, good for you, Notes Plus. But, it's basically the same thing as GoodNotes 4, Notability, but it does some things a lot better, like that scratching out. So the next app we're going to look at here is Cardflow. And unlike using an iPad like a legal pad or a notebook, it focuses on allowing you to use index cards without killing a whole forest worth of trees. And I really like this because it's a good way of arranging your ideas in a way that a traditional outline won't allow you to. It's basically a storyboard. You know, the way that screenwriters and novelists will put their ideas on the wall of index cards and rearrange them as needed. And this allows you to do that right here on the screen. And it's really cool because, you know, you can select multiple of them and therefore, you know, you can arrange them as you need. And I could add so many more cards to this. The problem is that I've noticed sometimes when you get too many cards, it'll sometimes crash. But other than that, I really love this way of doing it. You can also do it with text. You don't have to just use the pencil. You know, if you buy the premium version, there is actually a very good free version. You can add hyperlinks and images and stuff like that. And it makes it really useful. But again, I love this. It is actually my favorite outlining tool, and for similar reasons that you see with storyboards and the like. So today we've looked at 7 apps that all focus on writing by hand with the Apple Pencil on the iPad. They all have various strengths, and they did those strengths very well. But if I were to choose one that I would use every day and one that I would spend my money on, it would be Notability.